Good Morning Bay Street is a production of theuptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit theuptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Tuesday, January 13th, 2009. Yesterday I was out for lunch and one of the topics that came up was good news. And the question was, what good news am I expecting to cause the stock market to go up? And the answer is absolutely none. I'm not expecting any good news for years from now. We're in a bear market. When you're in a bear market, it's like riding a roller coaster. The roller coaster goes up, it goes down, it goes up, it goes down. And you know what? The whole time you're screaming. And that's what being in a market, in a bear market, is like. Now, we're going to continue to see lower numbers for bankruptcies or higher numbers for bankruptcies, foreclosures, unemployment, retail sales are going to continue to slump, immigration is going to decline, people are going to start going back home to where they immigrated from. So we're going to see worse numbers across the board for a long, long time, not expecting anything to turn around anytime soon. And the problem is, of course, U.S. real estate. And we're about 3 to 5 years away from the U.S. real estate crisis actually dissipating. We're about one third of the way through dealing with the bad mortgages that are out there. And, you know, it's not just bad mortgages. When you say bad mortgages, what you really need to think about is the fact that the equity or the savings of the average American has dropped dramatically in the last couple of years, and it's going to continue to drop over the next few years as U.S. real estate prices continue to decline. Now, it's only been recently that people started thinking of their homes as an investment tool, and they started to think about flipping their homes and upgrading their homes and selling their homes every couple of years, trying to make money. That is a very recent concept. The norm was that your home was a savings account. It wasn't an investment tool. You weren't competing with the stock market with your home. What you were doing was saving money every month when you were paying off your mortgage, as opposed to writing a check to your landlord and making your landlord rich. You know, it was a savings account. It was something that you looked forward to when you wanted to retire. You could sell your house or the kids could buy the house. But the norm was that, you know, you basically bought a house when you got married and you lived in it the rest of your life. The concept of flipping homes and trying to make quick bucks from buying and selling homes is a new concept. And people think that real estate prices continually go up over time. And, you know, here's a chart of over 100 years of U.S. real estate prices, inflation adjusted. And if you had bought a home during the real estate bubble of the 1890s, you would have had to have waited till the 1980s, nearly 100 years before you got your money back. If you had bought during the bubbles that happened in the first decade of the last century, you would have had to wait until World War II before you got your money back. So there are all times of periods of history in which real estate prices did not go up year after year after year. And right now we're dealing with this bubble that's exploding right now, and you have to expect that real estate prices are going to continue to fall year after year after year in this coming decade. Now, the next thing that's going to happen, of course, is commercial real estate prices are going to start to decline, and there's going to be a huge crash in commercial real estate. Now, right now, you're seeing that when you drive around and you look at the strip malls. You can see empty spaces just about everywhere you go. What you can't see right now is the empty spaces in office buildings. It's harder to see that unless you do a count of how many cars are in the parking lot. But, the commercial real estate crash is just starting, and it will take 3 to 5 years before it unwinds as well. Now, during a bear market, and this is a very unique bear market, of course, because this was the crash of 1929. But during a bear market, there are periods when the market tries to go higher. And it wasn't until 1932 that the market actually bottomed. So if this is the part that we've just gone through, you know, we may have to look forward to years and years and years of continual market declines. Now, right now, we are in a weekly uptrend, and that weekly uptrend looks very weak right now, but we're something like right there. And it would not be unusual if we, you know, close below the lower channel line and the market started to move lower right now. Until that happens, I'm going to try to remain bullish, but I'm not looking for any good news right now to turn the market around. Now, during a bear market and during a period of huge economic decline, the stock market during the 30s had long periods in which it started to rise. So even during periods of economic decline, and, you know, they called it the Great Depression for a reason, you know, the market went up. Now, in the late part of the 1930s, of course, World War II started. The U.S. didn't get involved in it until a couple of years later. But, you know, after they got involved in the war, look at the huge rallies that they had during the war. So you can have rallies during periods of economic downturn. You can have rallies during periods of war and destruction and death and foreclosures and bankruptcies and all that stuff. It's not only periods of good news in which the markets go up. So we're not looking for good news to spark, to cause the market to rise during these periods of economic downturn. Now, one of the things you don't want to do, so don't do it, is play with stocks that have the word bankruptcy tied around their necks. Now, Citigroup was down 17% yesterday. You know, people are still playing with General Motors. Both of these companies are technically bankrupt. Maybe they won't go bankrupt tomorrow, but at some point in the near future, they will go bankrupt. And one of the problems people have is that so many companies have gone bankrupt and come back. And what you don't realize that while the stock of the new company might be doing well, that the stockholders of the previous companies got totally wiped out. So there are lots of companies that have a history that have gone bankrupt and are now back and are active again and in the stock market. And so it could be true that, you know, Citibank is going to go bankrupt. A new Citibank, Citibank 2, could rise from the ashes and be traded on the stock market again in a couple years from now. That could also be true of General Motors. General Motors could go bankrupt, rise from the ashes. General Motors 2 could come out and be listed on the stock market and added once again to the Dow 30. That could happen. But what's important to remember is that the shareholders in those bankrupt companies get totally wiped out. So don't be confused when you see bankrupt companies back on the stock market doing well. It's really, you know, you're playing with fire. You do not, there are so many stocks out there that do not have the word bankruptcy tied around their neck that you do not have to take that risk. And during a bear market, that risk is so much higher than it is in a bull market. You do not need to play with those stocks whatsoever. So don't do it. Okay, so we're still working off that overbought condition. We talked about that, our 10-day the percentage of stocks trading above their 10-day moving average was incredibly high last week. We talked about that. We're still starting to move lower, hoping to get back down under that 10% mark, which would be another great buying opportunity. There's the TSX, the S&P 500 is getting pretty close to 10% right now. So is the NASDAQ. Looking at energy stocks, they've dropped dramatically down to the 30% area. So have bank stocks and gold's. Gold stocks are getting pretty close to the 10% area. So while getting down to under 10% does not guarantee a new buy signal right away, it is certainly a low risk area compared to buying up when the market breadth was up near 100%, which is a high risk buying opportunity. Okay, so today's breakpoints for Tuesday. Looking for the TSX, last time I looked, crude oil was down in the pre-market on Tuesday, so that's probably going to put more pressure on the TSX. We want an hourly close above 89.90 on Tuesday to give us a new hourly buy signal. For the S&P 500, we're looking for an hourly close above 885. For the NASDAQ, we're looking for an hourly close above 1565. And for the VIX, we're looking for an hourly close below 1475 to help confirm that the market is going to go higher. Until the VIX starts to close below 43.75, the pressure is still on the downside. Okay, that's all for Tuesday morning, folks. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Wednesday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's Good Morning Bay Street newsletter. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.